Today's video is going to be all about these. Yes, these glue-on nails that I do once a week. I absolutely love these. If you watch my favorites video, my latest favorites video, you saw that I featured these kiss nails. I really enjoy these because they do not super damage your nail. You can save a lot of money and have, you know, pretty good looking nails if you ask me. I think these are really nice looking. They're super easy and I paint them myself. Active square. So if these are the ones you want, make sure to get active square. Two of the easiest places to find these are Walmart and eBay. So check those places out. I'll leave a link below as well for you. But yeah, I really hope you enjoy this short tutorial. Let me know what else you'd like to see, whether that be beauty, lifestyle, health, or hair related. All right, talk to you soon. Peace and blessings. Bye. Okay, so let's get started. Of course, you're going to need the nails. Each package comes with 100, and these again are the active square. You'll need a polish. This is by Seche and it's called Siren, as well as a top coat and glue. Just a warning, this top coat is not really health conscious, so read your labels. That's all I'm gonna say for that. Once you have all of your materials gathered, go ahead and start sizing your nails, meaning you want to make sure that the nails you're selecting actually fit your nail bed. So take a nail, press it up against your nail bed, make sure that as it spreads, it's going to meet your cuticle, because you don't want that gap or an ugly gap. You also don't want it to be like over your cuticle either. So just test out the different sizes. I believe there are 8 or 9 different sizes that you can choose. Obviously, I know my sizes by heart for each and every finger or nail bed. So I chose those and then I grabbed my glue. So you take your maximum speed glue and I just use one drop and go ahead and place the nail or the plastic nail on there. 3 to 5 seconds is all it takes to have that really set. Obviously it's still drying, but you can move on to the next one. I would say all in all, this whole process takes me about 15 to 20 minutes, and that includes polishing my nails. This process is super fast, which again saves time for me. It saves money for me because I'm not going to the nail shop every week, and it's just so much easier. So a drop, you know, to make sure that you get the entire nail bed covered once you press down. Be careful not to use too much glue because then you'll get the glue oozing on the sides. And that actually prevents the nails from lasting a good week because it starts to separate from your cuticle and it just doesn't adhere to the nail bed. So just make sure you press down, get those sides, get the sides of your cuticle, and then move on. If you're just starting off doing this, be patient with yourself, you know, just take it slow. Don't think, okay, well, this is gonna be quick and easy, let me just throw these on. If it's your first time, take your time. So as you can see, I've got my nails on and I'm gonna just go ahead and file down the number. So each of these is actually numbered. That's how you can kind of remember what size your nail was for future uses. And there's just a little bit of plastic that's left on the top. So you wanna just file that down, make sure that that's not there so it doesn't snag on anything. When you are good to go with your nails, they're all glued on, you've got them filed. I don't do any filing on the sides. I don't do any of that because again, these nails pretty much fit your nail bed. There are so many different sizes in this pack that you should be able to find your size. On to the fun part, painting your nails. I actually really enjoy painting my nails. It's kind of like a little self-care thing that I do. It's very therapeutic because you do have to take your time. But I always get questions and requests for me to do other people's nails, mainly because, you know, the painting part of it. Just go slow. So the main thing you want to remember when you're painting your nails is to really press down. Make sure you have enough polish and then just press down and pull the polish up towards the top of your nail. You don't want to really go in with too much polish because that's going to probably end up, you know, getting a nick in it because it's taking too long to dry. Just apply your couple of coats. I think for this one, I did 3 coats. And just take your time. And it really does take practice to get good at just doing the motion. Like, my right hand always turns out not as accurate as my left, because when painting my right hand, I'm using my left hand. When I'm painting my left hand, I'm using my right. So my left hand always ends up being pretty good. And if you mess up, like I just did, go ahead and take a little nail polish remover and use that, or you can just wipe it off with your nail on your other hand, especially if that hand is dry or you haven't applied polish yet. So again, take your time, go slow, apply the right number of coats so that you can actually have some good looking nails instead of like a rushed job. So by the time I'm done with 1 coat on one hand, I can go ahead and go in with another coat on my other hand, because by that time it's pretty much dry, or at least dry enough for me to go ahead and paint my second coat. For this polish, I did 3 coats. I usually only do 2, but this was a really light color, and I was okay with it because I thought it was a really pretty color. It's like super light pink, or you know, darn near white. Again, read your labels. Read your labels for your ingredients on any of your nail polishes. But I decided to go ahead and use this one. I probably would not use this top coat on my bare nails, but because this is, you know, fake nails, I was like, yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and do this. So this is the Seche Sealant. I believe they call it the Seche Vite, but they're calling it the Sealant now. Really love this top coat, honestly. I wish it didn't have the ingredients that it does have in it. But I don't want to harp on that too much. I just want to show you guys that, you know, applying your top coat when your nails are pretty much dry is important. If you don't wait until your polish is set, you will experience like this super weird, almost like a dent in your nail polish, because you're pulling the polish off of your nail because it's not set. So just make sure that you wait till your polish is set and then go in with your sealant. And you don't have to glob the sealant on or the top coat on. You can do the same thing. Use one, you know, kind of thin coat of sealant or top coat and you should be good. Absolutely go and look at some fast drying polishes or top coats. I don't like the hard as nails one that says no cracking, because that actually does crack your nails. That one's from Sally Hansen. Take it from me. I don't do that. Don't get that one. But there are lots of good top coats out there. Honestly, guys, that's it. I just go ahead and let these dry. Here are some of my other nails that I used to do. Obviously, I've used my size in them. But I kind of go in when it comes to these. I like to play around with the different shapes. I do feel like the square, the active square, is the best suited for my nail bed. If you have a flatter nail bed, you might want to try the short oval, or you could try the short square. Those are really good as well, or even the long curve. So yeah, again, I really love playing around with these nails, but do give your nails, your natural nails, a fighting chance. Make sure to take care of them. I try to rub coconut oil on my natural nails to make sure that they are growing at a good pace. If you mess up, go ahead and just repaint really quick. That's what I was doing here. I kind of hit something, and so while my nails were still drying, I went ahead and took this top coat and just went ahead and fixed that up a little bit. Sometimes you may need to take a Q-tip and dip it in some nail polish remover and just kind of dab it on your nail to kind of help polish smooth out, and then go over it after you do that. But yeah, again, pretty simple. Hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Please let me know what else you'd like to see, if you'd like to see more nail designs. I'd love to get into that kind of stuff. So if you do have requests, please leave them below. Don't forget to follow me on all my social media outlets. Instagram at the KG Lifestyle, Twitter at the KG Lifestyle, I'm KG Lifestyle on Facebook. And leave me a comment, send me a request. I would love to hear what you guys think and would love to see what you would like to see next. All right, thanks for tuning in. Peace and blessings. Bye.